If you've been to a movie recently, some of these logos might look familiar. The name Dolby has become synonymous with entertainment. For years, it's outfitted theaters with its audio technology. It played a major role in developing stereo and surround sound and making the technology ubiquitous in theaters and consumers' homes.
Dolby played a big part in defining what movie-going audio was.
Although we largely associate Dolby today with movies, the company actually got its start in audio noise reduction.
Dolby was started by Ray Dolby in the 1960s with the idea that he could fundamentally improve the performance of tape recording. The challenge with tape was that it was noisy, and Ray figured out how to make it less noisy, which improved performance, but also enabled people to get more tracks on a single piece of tape. If you know the song Bohemian Rhapsody, that was an example of a song that was really made possible by the fact that you could get multiple tracks on the same piece of tape and build up a new way of using sound and building a sonic soundscape.
Dolby's noise reduction technology became a commercial success and quickly became the standard on audio cassettes and solidified Dolby's place in the industry. Today, Dolby is everywhere. If you go to a theater, its sound encoding technology enables the surround sound. When you pick up a DVD or Blu-ray, you'll find the Dolby logo on the back. That's because of its Dolby Digital audio compression technology, which is also used in all HD broadcasts in the US. Since it was founded 50 years ago, the company has grown to a market cap of $7 billion and brings in over $1 billion in revenue annually. With over 8,000 patents on its technology, 90% of Dolby's revenue comes from licensing that technology to content creators and OEMs. Dolby's latest focus is on two products, Dolby Atmos and Dolby Vision.
We had the idea that rather than just adding more channels, we could take a big step forward by now representing audio in three-dimensional space.
Dolby Atmos is a paradigm shift in how sound works. Traditionally, multi-channel sound has functioned as groups. Dolby Stereo, which was Dolby's first cinema sound technology, worked with four channels, a left and a right channel, as well as a center and surround channel for speakers in the rear of the theater. The 5.1 setup of Dolby Digital features six channels: center channel dedicated to dialogue, left and right channels to music and sound effects, one channel to the subwoofer, and left and right rear channels to sound effects. With Dolby Surround 7.1, it expanded upon this again by adding another set of left and right channels. Most every film released today is mixed in Dolby Surround 7.1. Atmos instead works in a spatial capacity, allowing up to 128 audio tracks to be distributed around all the speakers in an auditorium. This creates a more immersive sound experience for the audience.
We realized with that evolution, when talking to theater owners and the people creating content for the movie theaters, was adding more channels, it wasn't going to be enough of a step forward in terms of the experience. And so that's ultimately where the germ of the notion of Dolby Atmos came from.
On the visual end of the spectrum is Dolby Vision. Dolby's partnership with AMC Theaters started in 2015, when they started opening dedicated Dolby screening rooms with dual 4K Christie laser projection systems for Dolby Vision. The technology is Dolby's version of HDR, high dynamic range.
The key evolution with Dolby Vision relative to traditional imaging technologies is better pixels, darker darks and brighter brights, and colors that you've really never seen before on a screen.
HDR is another tool for the filmmakers to further immerse the audience in their stories. And this is as big a change as SD was to HD.
Moviegoers can experience this all packaged as Dolby Cinema. It's a cinema concept that competes with the likes of IMAX and other premium exhibition options. In partnership with AMC, the world's largest theater chain, it expanded the number of Dolby Cinema locations to 100 earlier this year, and just recently signed a partnership deal to increase the number of Dolby Cinemas in China. But Dolby is also aggressively expanding its technologies into our homes.
We're partnering with Netflix, with Amazon, with iQIYI in China, all of the major content delivery formats.
Content creators are increasingly utilizing the formats as a way to make watching TV shows and movies more immersive. One of the biggest adopters of the formats is Netflix, which now has over 500 hours of Dolby Vision content and over 100 for Atmos. And that continues to grow every day.
It was a great marriage with Dolby when they came out with Dolby Vision and Atmos. We really saw those as opportunities to level up the quality of the picture and the sound, and also to provide great opportunities to our filmmakers and showrunners to tell stories in new ways. We've always wanted to show movies and TV shows as they were intended, in the highest quality possible.
Dolby is betting big on Dolby Atmos and Dolby Vision becoming the new standard for audio and visuals. But as consumers, we may take for granted how much goes on behind the scenes to make our products look and sound great.
Dolby is one of the few companies in the world that has the patience to bring an experience like Dolby Vision and Dolby Atmos to the world. Very often, it takes a decade or more to actually fully realize the vision of something like Dolby Vision and Dolby Atmos. We had to reimagine the tools that audio editors and sound designers would need. Distribution partners and playback partners, we had to work with them to evolve their distribution channels and their playback products to conceive of now audio in three-dimensional space.
The distinct advantage of Atmos over previous multi-channel audio is that content only needs to be mixed once, and can then play properly on many different devices, regardless of speaker configuration.
One of the reasons that content creators and content distributors love Dolby Atmos and Dolby Vision is that they scale. They scale all the way from the movie-going experience down to a mobile phone.
The fact that the technology scales benefits consumers as they increasingly watch content on the go. This is where Dolby is focusing its efforts next, bringing the same technology they use in theaters to all of our portable devices.
We're not ready to accept that portability always comes at the cost of a poor audio or imaging experience.
To integrate this technology into devices, Dolby has over 100 labs to test and configure the optimal audio and visual experience.
We have very sophisticated labs where we're able to, in real time, model out how an end consumer will actually experience Dolby Atmos and Dolby Vision, and in an iterative way, evolve the designs.
Not all that different from what launched the company back in the 60s with Ray Dolby and his quest to fix recording noise, the engineers and teams at Dolby are constantly looking at ways they can enhance the content we love to watch.
We've got 900 or 1,000 people who are just intrinsically working on getting the last decibel out of sound performance, making sure that the video just looks a little bit brighter. So even though we are small, we can really focus our talent and our intellectual horsepower on specific elements that make an absolute difference to consumers, video and audio.